success of New York's Municipal Orphanage on the night of December 31st, 1922.
And now, our conducting post-pope nationwide search for any parents?
Yes, I am now conducting a nationwide coast-to-coast search for any parents. Drop page. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any person who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
Wow! So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station, or directly to him at...
At my home, Bernie Healy, 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank the makers of all new Oxygen Toothpicks, Miracle L64 to fight bad breath, for letting me appear here this evening. I just did a dark commercial. Chris, I never endorsed a product.
Good evening, Oliver Warbucks. Thanks for dropping by, Oliver Warbucks. So, Annie's parents, if you're listening, there's $50,000 and a wonderful little daughter here waiting for you. So get in touch right away, you hear?
Hey, Marie Healy, isn't it time once again for the lovely Glenn sisters?
It most certainly is, Wacky. Well, I can see by the old clock on the wall that it has one of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say oxygen.
O-X-Y-D-E-N-T.
The toothpaste of your stars to make your teeth Hollywood bright.
Thank you.
We're gonna fool Mr. Warbucks too.
We'll get ourselves 50,000 ping pong.
This is gonna be the best Funko job ever, Adam. I know a guy out of jail who can doctor up some big sorts of kits or any other paper game. But we need your help, sis, for information about Annie that can help us pull this thing.
Sure. I've been talking a lot around. But what's in it for me?
Three-way split tag.
Half.
Half!
Half!
Half, half, half. Straight down the middle. 25 grand. We gotta do it fast, Abby. Feeling kind of old, Rooster Razzle Dazzle. In and out, 2 or 3 minutes at most. Get the money, get the kid, and get out of town.
Yeah, the kid, Annie. That's the problem. What are we gonna do with her afterward?
Annie, that's no problem.
When the rooster wants something to disappear, it disappears.
Very good.
Rooster.
Ah, come on, Aggie. We can get the 50 grand and blow this crummy town, then little me will meet you.
Wait. Oh, yeah.
Well, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left,
I'd like to begin with your views on manners.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. Yes, and for the good of you, the country, Wall Street, and me, we have got to keep my factories open and the workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, 15 million Americans are without work, and nearly 50 million Americans have no means of support. Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our biggest problem. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany. People are starving in this country.
Helen, I know that. But in the long run, we're not.
Cordell, for people starving, there is no long run.
The truth is, the stock market has taken another nosedive.
Sit down, strikes, riots,
floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone. Well, I guess we're all agreed on one thing. The situation is hopeless and getting worse.
Hannah, I'd like to see those figures.
The time now.
Shh! Quiet, little girl!
Helen! What did you say, Annie? That's all right. Go ahead, my dear. It's still a free country.
Just about tomorrow.
Immediately. You don't mind?
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Eddie.
Bye, Mr. President.
A Duesenberg is a car. Babe Ruth is the right fielder for the New York Yankees, and there's something else you should know. I've made me a fortune, that fortune's made ten. Flowers.
Flowers.
Caviar.
Caviar.
Champagne.
Champagne.
you like? Johnny Rockefeller? Babe Ruth? Madame Shanghai Shek? She's a lot of fun.
Well, I guess I like Miss Farrell here. And Drake, and Miss Pugh, Annette, Cecile, Miss Greer. I guess I like everybody here.
Of course, that's what I'd like too. Drake?
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids?
No, it'll be way past their bedtime. But I'll tell you what. I'll have everyone from the orphanage here tomorrow morning for a big Christmas party.
And Miss Hannigan, too?
Miss Hannigan, too. Why not?
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is, I'm based on your words, sir, getting spiffed up for the party.
Ah, yes. Perhaps Annie and I should be spiffed up, too. Grace?
Yes, sir.
How's your suit put? Why, Grace, that's a very lovely dress.
Thank you, sir.
Have Cecile put Annie into one of her new dresses and have Annette do something with her hair. I don't know, take her upstairs and I'll dress her up.
Yes.
Or else he'd go kerplunk. There are two of
Don't mean to interrupt, but look, Cheryl, there she is.
Who are you? Honey, where are your mom and dad?
Mudge. Mudge is his name. Not Mudge. And this here's the wife, Shirley.
You wouldn't know it, dear, but you're Amy Mudge.
Amy Mudge?
He was sick and broke, honey, and didn't know which way to turn. But a man gave us a chance to work up on his farm in Canada.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
I'm sorry, Annie, but we had to leave him behind.
Mr. Mudge, is it? Do you realize
this? Oh, proof. I expect him to be one thing. Proof of who we are. He was our driver's license and ain't perfect.
Baby girl named Ann Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th, 1922. That's my birthday. It was in your notes, sir.
Yes, I know,
Mister. Mister. You gotta believe us. We got on the Greyhound this afternoon. Went straight to the orphanage. But the lady up there said that our baby was up here.
Oh, Annie, all the years I dreamed of holding you in my arms again. Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie left.
I hear something you wouldn't know about. But when you left Annie at the orphanage, we also left half a silver up. So that one day.
Rob, look, she's wearing it.
Oh, and here's up for our weekend. Yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph. She's our Annie.
She is. She is.
Seems to be.
Well, you'll get Annie's things together. We'll be taking her along.
Take her?
No!
Now wait just a moment, Mr. Mudge. What about the money?
Money? Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever for our Annie.
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check for $50,000 to any person who can prove that they are Annie's parents?
No, sir. We ain't heard about no check. Anyway, you don't want Annie.
Right. We don't want no kind.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that little pig farm up in New Jersey? With that $50,000, we could buy it and raise Annie up right in the country. Fresh air, fresh eggs.
Fresh ham.
Yeah. Fresh hands. Certified, huh? All I gotta do is make it up for myself?
Yes, tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning!
Yes, you wouldn't mind if we kept Annie here until tomorrow morning, Christmas, and then you can come back to pick her up and the check.
Oh.
A problem?
I don't know, sir. Whatever you say is fine. Anyway, you better be getting back to the hotel now. Goodbye, Annie. Until tomorrow morning, honey. And you will spend the rest of your life with us.
Goodbye, Angelo.
Oops. Pardon me, Andrew. Merry Christmas.
Season's greetings, one and all.
Well, this is wonderful news, Annie.
That's wonderful.
Annie has found her parents, and they seem to be a very nice couple.
You're lucky, Annie.
Right. I'm lucky. Just think, a pig farm.
Miss Greer, a champagne. We must celebrate because it's Christmas Eve and we just had the most wonderful news. Annie has found her mother and father. Everyone, I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas.
Oh, it seemed to have the same effect on everyone.
Lost her. Lost Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before, but I just can't remember where or what. But I have the strangest feeling he has not been existence.
Mr. President.
Franklin.
Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver, whatever I can do for you.
Mr. Well, we've been up all night, dear. We've hacked a ton of it. FBI men coming and going. Annie, you know that President Roosevelt's here?
Really?
Got something very difficult to tell you. The President's going to help me tell it to you.
Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, President Roosevelt. How are you?
Pretty good. It's good to see you again.
Good to see you too, sir.
Franklin.
Annie, walk with me. Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the paper and handwriting on your note, he succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, we already know that. Mr. and Mrs. Mudd.
No, dear. They're your parents. Your parents were David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Were they?
Annie, your parents passed away a long time ago.
They're dead?
Yes, dear.
So I'm an orphan after all, just like all the other kids.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes, because I always knew they were dead, because if they loved me, then they would come back to me if they were.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you too, Mr. Warbucks. Now who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Atta girl. Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Well, the birth certificate could easily have been forged. But the thing is, they knew about the locket.
The locket! That's your key.
But the only people who knew about the locket were us. And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan!
Miss Hannigan, sir, I'm a children from the orphanage.
Ah, Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to finally meet you.
Same here.
And I know you, anyways. You're the Oliver Warbucks, right?
That is correct, Miss Hannigan. Let me introduce you to some of my staff. You already know my secretary, Grace Farrell, of course.
Yeah.
And this is the President of the United States.
Sure.
And this is my brother, Greg. Fraud is a federal offense, and your Secret Service men have the power to arrest.
They most certainly do, Oliver. Great, will you turn them over? The jig is up.
Annie, tell them how good and nice I always was to you.
I would love to, Miss Hannigan, but what's the one thing you always taught me? Oh yeah, never tell a lie.
Brat! I'll let you know a little secret. I never liked you, you little gold digger.
Our father.